Cavalcade of Metal. Today we've got three special guests, Killer Dwarves. We got Yngwie Malmsteen and the man headlining tonight's performance, Ronnie James Dio. Ronnie, thanks for being here.
Pleasure. I love it down here.
First album in about 3 years. What took so long to do this record?
Well, I was kind of on this schedule of the things that most bands do, most people do, record an album, rehearse, tour, get off the tour, write for an album, record an album, rehearse, tour, and if you say it enough times, it becomes pretty mindless, and that's what was happening. The only way to write is with experiences, and the only experiences I had were hotel rooms, same ones all the time, same faces, the same thing. So I wanted to take about a year off. In the meantime, I talked to the guitar player and said, you know, we don't seem to be doing very well, you and I, writing together. What do you think? And he said, yeah, I think you might be right. I don't think I'm the right person for you. So like something that never happens, we parted friends. Really amazing, huh? Wow. I mean, no fights, nothing. And he still remains a friend to this day. And that was Craig Goldie, our last guitar player.
Right.
So we had to bring in another guitar player. We had to find one. So that took me about 8 months. Listened to 5,000 tapes. Finally, about in the middle of all the 5,000, about number 2,500, I heard this kid and went, whoa, listen to that, this guy's great. And he was just what I wanted. He was an English kid. I usually play with English players most of my life anyway. So I played it for everybody and said, this is great. And then I read the letter and saw the picture. And he was only 17 years old. And he looked much younger than that. And so we waited for another 2,500 people. And I mean, there was just nobody even close to him. His name is Rowan Robertson. He's a wonderful player. The thing I was concerned about most was he too young and we too old? Did it mean we were going to have the patience to deal with him or not? So we brought him over. And first thing he did was insult us, of course, and we loved him right away. You know, he said the drummer's feet were too big, and then he tripped over something. So he was, you know, was perfect for us. He's a great kid, wonderful player, and he was just absolutely perfect. And I knew when I heard the tape that he should have been the one. It was only the personality thing. So I have to tell you the story that I didn't tell you off the air. A friend of mine, David Coverdale, from Whitesnake, obviously, as most people probably know, was recording across the way where we were rehearsing, and everyone had heard the buzz about this. Well, Dio's got this guy, 17 years old, this can't be. So David came over, we said hello, and he said, I've got to see this, got to meet this kid. So he went in, and there was Rowan, and I said, this is Rowan Robertson, David Coverdale. And Coverdale said to him, man, you look like you're 12 years old. Rowan said, no, I look like the age you'd like to be.
Yikes! Yeah,
so, I mean, his job was sealed right at that point, you know? It was
right
great.
On.
And David liked it, too, you know? So it was cool.
I guess it's too early to do any writing with him yet, is it? Or
We wrote on this last album. In fact, he and I wrote everything on this last album with some help from, you know, different.
But you use the word people. Experiences. I mean, probably a 17-year-old kid, what kind of experiences can he really?
Well, it's not that difficult when, you know, you don't have to have a lot of experiences to play the instrument. I'm talking about more experiences, about life experiences.
True.
I mean, I have to write, you know, lyrically everything, and I mean, I just didn't want to write about the same things. I'm always accused of being Mr. Wizard, you know, Mr. Witch and Mr. Sword and Sorcery kind of guy. And I think with the time off we took, I started to write a little bit more like as if this album were kind of my psychiatrist's couch. It was a chance for me to get all these things pent up inside of myself off for 3 years, and none of them were concerned with wizards and witches. It was just like, you know, all the things I'd experienced around me. So I wrote different things, and another story you'll like. One of the tracks on this album was inspired by a restaurant across the street from here.
Really?
Yeah, there's a deli across the street that sells good beer, by the way. We had come here 3 years ago to do something, and you weren't ready, as usual. So I said, well, there's a place across the street you can get hair of the dog, because we certainly needed it that night. We had come in from Montreal, and we had been pretty wasted the night before. So we went across, and I noticed this big chalkboard, and it had a list of the food for the day. And one of the foods was a sandwich. It was called Evil on Queen Street. And one of the songs on the album is called Evil on Queen Street.
I wondered, I was flipping through, I wonder if that was one.
That's exactly what it was. Yeah, it was the sandwich. The song's not about a sandwich, of course, but judging from some of the people I see on Queen Street, it's pretty apropos, I think.
No kidding.
Yeah.
We meet them.
Yeah. You know, I mean, I thought it was weird down here, but basically more weird up there.
So how did you get Simon Wright to play with your band?
Well, Simon was in the middle of, he had just finished pre-production for what will be the next AC/DC album. Vinny had gone about 2 weeks before we were prepared to go into the studio. Didn't know what I was going to do. I mean, what do you do? How do you replace somebody as good as Vinny? So the first person I thought of was Simon, because I'd known Simon for about 8 years. I met Simon first at Donington. We did our first Donington show. He had just gotten the gig with AC/DC. And his first show was going to be Madison Square Garden. the kid was only 18 years old then, so he was like Rowan at the time, you know, like, right. Wow, what's happening to me? Anyway, we became really fast friends, and I loved the way he played. He's just such a smacker, and he's a little guy as well. So when it came to think of someone to play on this album, I called Simon, and Simon luckily had 3 weeks between the end of pre-production that he had just done and to go up to Little Mountain, I think is where they're going to do the next album. So I said, well, could you, would you? And he said, I'd love to, I'll ask if I can. And so he asked the powers that be, I guess the Young family, and I guess they said yes. So he came down, we had 5 days of rehearsal, went bang, straight in the studio in Reno, Nevada, and he played, and he went away, he left, and we got everything done in time, so he was off to do the thing with AC/DC. I got a call about 2 weeks later, and he said, I'm free. I'm not gonna be playing with the band anymore. Is the job still open? Hey, it's open, I'll come and pick you up, and I'll give you a horseback ride.
You mentioned Reno, Nevada. Now, it said that when you were going to record the record, you took the whole band to Reno, and you lived all together or something?
Right, right. We wanted a studio, and we've done this before, in the old days, Rainbow days and Black Sabbath days. We would always, or normally, most of the time, would go to a place where we could all be self-contained. We would all live there because, again, there are experiences that get created that way. You know, you get to know each other real well. After the album's done, you're closer because it's you against the world. That's what happens. Plus the fact that you go to a place like Reno where it was cold as hell. I guess hell's not that cold these days. Anyway, it was cold. Cold as Toronto in the wintertime. And you want to get the hell out of there. I mean, you don't want to be there anymore, you know, so you get your job done. But it was for, you know, for being close together. The studio, we lived where the studio was in the same place, a place called Granny's House. It was an old Victorian home. And Reno's a great rock and roll town. We'd go to a club every night and play most of the time. And so we really got our jobs done in a couple ways. We did the album and we got to know each other musically and personally. So that's the reason we went to Reno. And that again was suggested by David Coverdale again. So he keeps creeping into this album someplace and he didn't sing on it, no.
So how long is this, this tour gonna be?
This tour will probably last well after the first of the year. We began this tour with 5 shows in Europe with Metallica. We did 5 festival shows with Metallica, 2 in Holland, 2 in Germany, 1 we finished in Paris. Then we did 5 shows of our own in Britain. And now we've started, this one started on August the 1st with Yngwie. September the 1st, we go back to Germany again and we do, here we go again. We do 1 festival show with Whitesnake, Aerosmith, and there's Coverdale creeping back in again.
Here we go again. Boys, here and, I go again.
And there you go.
There you go.
I didn't say that. You said it. It's your fault, not mine. And then we'll come back and we'll do another phase of it here, and then we'll go to Europe again, and to Japan, and Australia, and
so tonight,
wherever.
Killer Dwarves,
right?
Yngwie,
right?
You guys, what are we going to get from you?
Well, we always bring a big stage set with us. You know, we try to follow the footsteps of Alice Cooper, the godfather of stage sets. So we brought something that looks a lot like what you see on the album cover, a lot of desolation and bones that have decayed in the sand, pyrotechnics, moving parts, farm animals. No, no farm animals. Nothing like that. We'll leave that to Andrew Dice Clay. Just the things that we're famous for, you know, a lot of good music and a great band.
Okay, we're going to see Wild One. And we're going to thank you for being here.
Thanks, Dan.
Good luck tonight. And if you don't have a ticket, or if you need a ticket, or if you want to see the show, get your butts down to C&E. Check it out, because it should be a good show.
It'll be good.
Wild One. Right, deal.